For the last two decades, China has been seen as the world's manufacturer, churning out cheap gadgets and gizmos for the rest of the planet to enjoy. But now, it's starting to look like that's all about to change. Because while Chinese companies are still making plenty of hardware, they're increasingly becoming the ones that own the software inside them too. And this trend was only highlighted further by this week's news that Chinese chip giant, well, Huawei, has unveiled its brand new full-stack self-developed operating system called Hongmeng, or Harmony. So what does this mean for the future of tech? And why should you care? Well, here's why. Because with HarmonyOS, China may finally be on track to breaking free from its reliance on U.S. tech giants like Microsoft and Google and become the world's true tech leader. Let's dive in. HarmonyOS was officially unveiled at the annual Huawei Developer Conference, which took place in Shenzhen on 2021, where CEO Richard Yu gave a keynote speech highlighting how the company has achieved breakthroughs in four areas: security and energy efficiency, power network, connectivity cloud services, and the developer ecosystem. Now, these are pretty big claims, and if you remember back in 2021, Yu had already claimed that Huawei had developed a fully self-developed operating system that could rival Windows Android and iOS, although at the time he didn't mention anything about the OS being based on Linux. However, that's no longer the case because this time around, Richard Yu proudly announced that HarmonyOS is based on open-source code and standards and complies with international practice. In other words, Huawei isn't trying to reinvent the wheel, but instead is leveraging the strengths of Linux, while also incorporating a number of proprietary components to make it more tailored to its needs. But even with Linux at its core, HarmonyOS is still an incredibly ambitious project. That's because unlike Android, which is primarily a mobile operating system, HarmonyOS aims to span across all of Huawei's product lines from smartphones and tablets to laptops, wearables, and even smart home appliances. It's almost like Apple's vision of a seamless ecosystem. Except instead of being centered around a single device, HarmonyOS is designed to unify multiple devices and platforms. For example, HarmonyOS can enable your phone to automatically connect to your laptop or tablet, seamlessly switch between different screens depending on your preferences, and even allow you to control your smart home appliances with just a few taps. This interoperability is made possible by Huawei's SuperDevice feature, which essentially allows any two devices running HarmonyOS to work together regardless of their specific functions. The company first introduced SuperDevice back in 2020, but the new version takes things one step further by enabling features like multi-screen collaboration, supercasting, and multi-device management. Multi-screen collaboration allows you to use multiple devices simultaneously, such as a phone and a tablet, while supercasting enables you to easily share media and files across devices. Meanwhile, multi-device management allows you to control other devices from your phone, such as adjusting the volume on your headphones or switching inputs on your TV. Now there's a lot of benefits to having a unified operating system across all your devices. It simplifies the user experience, reduces fragmentation, and most importantly, it gives Huawei more control over its products. As we've seen with Apple and Microsoft, having control over your entire stack, including the operating system, hardware, and software, allows you to create a more tightly integrated and secure ecosystem. What's more, it also gives you greater freedom to innovate without being dependent on third-party technologies. This is particularly important for Huawei, which has been cut off from many U.S. technologies since 2019. And it's one of the main reasons why the company has been investing heavily in developing its own software and hardware technologies, including its self-developed Kirin chips. Of course, despite these advancements, Huawei still relies on Android for its smartphones. But with HarmonyOS, the company is gradually reducing this dependency. According to Richard Yu, as of April, 70% of Huawei's phones were already running HarmonyOS 3, which marked a significant increase from the previous year. Moreover, Huawei plans to roll out HarmonyOS 4 later this year, which will be available on 100 million devices. While Huawei has made some good progress so far, the real test will come when the company releases its own laptops powered by HarmonyOS. According to you, Huawei's first HarmonyOS-powered laptops will hit the market in September. And if they gain enough traction, the company will consider expanding HarmonyOS to other PC makers. Now, this might sound like a daunting task given the dominance of Windows in the PC market, but don't count Huawei out just yet. That's because PCs aren't exactly known for their innovation, especially compared to the smartphone market. So if Huawei can create a compelling user experience with HarmonyOS, it could entice some users to give it a try. Plus, with Microsoft recently increasing the price of Windows, there might be a growing number of businesses looking for an alternative operating system that offers a similar level of compatibility and functionality without the hefty price tag. HarmonyOS could be just what they're looking for. That said, for HarmonyOS to truly succeed, Huawei needs to address some of the shortcomings of its current implementation. One of the biggest challenges that Huawei faces is the lack of apps optimized for HarmonyOS. While the company has built its own app store called App Gallery, which offers a wide range of applications, many of them are not well optimized for the platform, leading to performance issues and a poor user experience. To solve this problem, Huawei has been working on a solution called Mi AI, which is essentially a set of tools that allows developers to easily port their existing apps to HarmonyOS. Huawei has also been encouraging developers to create more HarmonyOS-specific apps through various programs and initiatives. Nevertheless, it remains to be seen whether these efforts will be enough to convince users to ditch their familiar Windows PCs for something entirely new. After all, users are creatures of habit, and changing their operating systems can be a daunting task, especially for businesses that rely on mission-critical applications. But if Huawei can demonstrate that HarmonyOS can meet the needs of its users, then it might just have a chance at succeeding where others have failed. Still, while Huawei's HarmonyOS might be getting a lot of attention lately, it's not the only thing worth keeping an eye on. That's because Huawei's fellow Chinese tech giant Tencent is also working on its own operating system, codenamed Hongyan. Tencent is a major player in China's tech scene, best known for its popular messaging app WeChat and its social media platform QQ. But the company has been expanding into other areas such as gaming, fintech, and cloud computing. Developing its own operating system is part of Tencent's strategy to reduce its dependence on Microsoft and other third-party vendors and to gain more control over its technology stack. Tencent has been testing Hongyan internally for several years and reportedly plans to release it to the public sometime in 2024. Like Huawei, Tencent has also been investing heavily in its own software and hardware technologies. For example, the company recently launched its own cloud gaming platform called Start, and it's also working on its own chips called Tangula. These efforts are part of Tencent's strategy to build a more resilient and independent technology ecosystem that is not reliant on foreign vendors. By developing its own operating system, Tencent would be able to offer its customers a more integrated and customized solution that meets their specific needs. Additionally, it would also create more opportunities for innovation and differentiation, allowing Tencent to develop new features and services that are tailored to its ecosystem. Overall, the development of Hongyan represents an important step in China in its efforts to reduce its reliance on foreign technology and to build a more self-sufficient tech industry. With Tencent and Huawei both working on their own operating systems, the competition in the space is likely to intensify, leading to more innovation and better products for consumers. And while it remains to be seen how these Chinese operating systems will fare against established players like Microsoft and Apple, one thing is clear. China is becoming increasingly sophisticated in its approach to technology and is no longer content with simply being a manufacturer of cheap gadgets. Instead, Chinese companies are now looking to become true innovators and leaders in the global tech industry. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching this video. And if you're interested in more content like this, please consider subscribing and supporting us. We would really appreciate it.